One of the largest studies on vaping ever done. A UNMC researcher is leading the charge.
And she's part of a team that's already discovered young people who vape may have changes in their brains.
It's a major reason to quit nicotine as soon as possible or never start.
Dr. Daisy Dye is fascinated with all things nicotine.
They need to get help.
The professor and associate dean of research at UNMC's College of Public Health says the impacts of vaping and smoking are her life's work. She believes chronic use can also trigger mental health issues.
Once the nicotine level in the body goes down, people actually become more depressed and need more nicotine.
And this is groundbreaking. Dr. Dye and colleagues are discovering the physical impacts on young brains. Their study, published in the Journal of the American Medical Association, or JAMA, they studied 11,000 young people at age 9 to 10 and used MRIs to scan their brains.
Here is the brain imaging that we show.
Among those who use nicotine,
the cortical area is thinner and the volume tends to be smaller.
The evidence is in blue. Young nicotine users had smaller brains and shrunken areas, and they tested poorly compared to non-users when it came to thinking skills, with sustained effects 2 years later.
This could impact their memory or impact their speech, because those are the functioning areas related to their cognitive performance.
But was it nicotine that caused the changes? Now there's a new study recently awarded by the National Institute of Health. Dr. Dye will lead the study on brain health of 11,000 young people over the course of 10 years, so from the ages of 10 to 20, studying the impact of nicotine on the growing brain over time.
This is a cutting-edge study, and it takes the whole village across the country to complete the study.
There are 21 test sites across the country, and children will have lab tests, MRIs, and cognitive testing.
We want to compare the brain status before using the substance versus after the substance use,
so that families have solid answers and kids have clear directions to quit or never start.
We don't want the children to be left alone in this difficult journey. Many kids want to quit.
With 2.5 million middle school and high school students reporting recent use, it's critical data that can serve as a smoke signal for change.
So Dr. Dye says help your children quit. Go see your pediatrician. They can help with nicotine patches or gum, or see a substance use therapist. You can go to this website. It's part of Dr. Dye's efforts to help kids quit. It's called teamtobaccofree.org. There are quit plans for kids and adults.